this session will be a continuation of the talk that Mark Francis from Intel gave in 2014, stating that the future of healthcare is fashion. So I wanted to continue that that particular thought, and Katia Vega, who works at MIT Media Lab as a postdoctorate student and amazing designer, will share with us some examples of how beauty technology can be connected with cosmetics. And if you connect that with clothing that can be embedded with circuits that are flexible at this point and can be woven into fabrics, you get the new era of consumer healthcare, and you won't have to actually ask consumers, would you like to wear this device, because it will be embedded in your blouse, skirt, jacket. It will be there for them to use if they choose to, and after a while, it will be everybody will be using it, so the big data will be even bigger. The introduction of Katia will be including her background from Peru. Yes, born in Peru, and she studied computer science in Brazil and Hong Kong, and now she's at MIT doing amazing things. So we can't wait to hear from you.
Thank you very much for the introduction. Yes, my name is Katia Vega, and now I am a postdoc at MIT Media Lab. And what I have been doing is something that I call beauty technology, and that was my research for the last, I think, 4 or 5 years ago. And that's what I wanted to talk to you about. And for me, it's kind of very interesting to show this technology to you. Normally, I'm in different venues, like more techie or more fashion. So I would love to know your ideas and to share with you, what do you think about this? So I came to you to talk about cosmetics. And is it okay? Okay, great. Yeah, so if you think about cosmetics, in the industry of cosmetics, or the functionality of cosmetics, it didn't change over the time. I'm wearing now this red lipstick, and my mom had a red lipstick. And also my grandma had a red lipstick. So we use that for enhance our beauty, for making highlight some part of our appearance, or also hide some part of our appearance. But the functionality of the cosmetics is the same. What I'm proposing is to add a new functionality to these cosmetics to still look it pretty, or to still enhance or highlight or hide some part of your body, but now with some superpowers. And so for understanding this, I bring this diagram that is about on-body technology. So where we do place technology? We could place technology on things that we carry with us. For example, your smartphone is something that you carry with us, but you are not actually wearing it. We have technology nowadays that are inside of the body. Even you can buy online your RFID chips and inject it into your body. But also we have technology on the body. And I think that they will have been talking about this in these also presentations over these days. So we have technology on the body in a way of wearables. And I call these wearables in a way that it could be on clothes or accessories. Clothes like a smart t-shirt or accessories as Google Glass. We have some examples today. But on the body is also the skin. And it's the skin and its appendages that it could be the fingernails and hair. So that's what I came to talk about you. And my proposal is called beauty technology. So what I do is I use cosmetics. I didn't invent cosmetics. Maybe Cleopatra have the patents about cosmetics. So I use cosmetics in a way of there is this element that we are wearing every day but now with electronics inside. And we place technology into skin, fingernails, and hair. And I will show you some examples about it. So we created this project that we call it conductive makeup. What I did, I went to a drugstore and I buy these fake eyelashes. But with a chemical process, I metallize these fake eyelashes. And imagine if I put one up and one down, and I connect that with also a conductive eyeliner, so I could connect your blinking. And blinking have a lot of information. So for example, when you close your eyes, it's about like 100 and 150 milliseconds that your eyes close every time you're blinking. If you are tired or if you are boring, if this presentation is too boring, you will be blinking slowly. So we can understand different things of blinking. And I have been using that in a way to having voluntary blinking for interacting with the world. So here are some examples. The first one over the right is, I call it Blinkifier. Blinkifier is an art project that we developed in Hong Kong. And when the model, she blinks, she could change different patterns of her blinking in this headdress. And we have been showing in different exhibitions this piece. But also we could think about having these technologies. For example, the first one is an actress, and she, at the theater, she could change the lights and she could change the music that is around her. And the last one, that's me. I'm a superhero in my free time. And this was a contest, and we won the contest with this project that we will have. So we try to augment the human capacities having this superhero project, and with blinking, we could levitate objects. So with just blinking, I could make this drone to fly. And so this project, the superhero project, was a lot in the media, and a lot of people talk about it because, wow, it's super cool to blink and have a drone to fly. But it was something interesting also happened to me. That it was this guy, that is, his name is Felipe. I was presenting in different fairs this project, and Felipe came to me. And he is a very interesting approach because he said to me, I would like to use your technology. He was twice world championship in jiu-jitsu, 6 times Brazilian championship. And after a training, he get injured, and now he has this disability. He cannot walk. And he told me, like, there are simple things for you that could be, for example, turning on the TV or changing the channel. But for me, I always depend on someone. And I would like to have the freedom of changing the channels and not wasting 30 minutes of my life without doing anything. And of course, I will not put eyelashes in a guy. So we create this other project that we call it Effects in Makeup. So instead of using the eyelashes, what we did is we analyzed the face muscles. And we have like 43 face muscles that they move individually, also in conjunction with other muscles. And we put this switch, and we hide this switch with special effect makeup. So in this way, we create this project for Felipe that we call it Winky Mode. And with his blinking, when he blink with his right or left or both eyes, he could control the TV. And also in the same way to present this project and to show the possibilities of having this technology, we create this other project that is called Kinesi. And Kinesi means movement in Greek. And we are using also this project as an art project that has been shown in Barbican in London, in Stockholm, now it's in Athena with digital futures. And it's a way to have your body or your face as an interactive platform. So when you raise your eyebrow, when you blink, when you smile, when you close your lips, you could interact with different devices. In this case, it's an art piece that is have LEDs on her hair and her face. So I will show you a video. This is a video that we have been showing around the world. So we have been talking about skin, and we say that we will be talking about the body surface. So fingernails are also part of the body surface. These are my fingernails. I took this picture yesterday, and these are these fingernails. And what I have been doing in the last year is something that I call tech nails. So I create these fingernails with chips inside. In this case, I have RFIDs. RFID is this technology that we use for opening your door of the office. So maybe I could open with this one, or maybe pay the meter with other one. So we can have this technology in our fingernails now in a very decorative and nice way. So I have been using this in different ways, as I don't need to touch the object for interacting with it. For example, I did this piano in the air, because my fingernails needs to be like 2 centimeters away from the reader. So I could have each note as a fingernail, and we can play the piano with that. But also, instead of having a box, we can have, like the first one, we have this belt. And in this case, the pianist, she went down the scenario, and she moves to the audience, and she was playing through her body. And I also, sometimes I wear it, not this time, but sometimes I wear it and use that for controlling the computer and changing the slides and interacting with other applications. And if you see, I don't need to touch the object. So if I don't need to touch the object, I could also have other applications around it. So I did this project that I call it Aquadigging. What it does is an aquarium, and I put water inside because I wanted to explore and to show a new water interface too. So when the DJ put her fingernails into the water, she could change the tracks and add special sound effects. So it's a DJ controller into the water. We have been talking about skin, fingernails. Now we'll be talking about hair. Because hair is something that it's visible. You also could see my hair. It's malleable. I could make different hairstyles. And in some ways, it's personal. No one comes and mess my hair. But also, it has another tool. We use hair as another tool. So we use hair when we think about something, when we are stressed, so we can define different patterns about that. It's also a flirting device. Girls touch their hair to show, to mimic like as a kid, or to show more the neck to their partner. And all these behaviors are unconscious. So we touch our hair in an unconscious way. And the proposal here is how we can use these unconscious behaviors, but consciously, for interacting with other devices. So in this way, we create a project that we call it hairwear. Hairwear is also conductive hair. Then when you touch the hair, you could connect with a smartphone and send a message, record a conversation. If you are in danger, you can send your location to the police or your family. And I will show you a video too, so you could have a better idea of it. So these key interfaces, these beauty technologies that I showed you before, we developed them in a way to hide technology, that in a way that these devices look as part of your body, like cosmetics does. So it's a way to have invisible wearable technologies. But also we can have skin interfaces that are visible. And this is some project that I have been developing at MIT Media Lab in the last months that I arrived in September. The first one, we call it Carnival Mask. We create 300 masks in the Halloween event for the kids. And we were doing that with face painting and makeup artists. So they were wearing these face maze masks with different designs, like a butterfly or Batman or whatever they wanted. And they went to the haunted house, and we could control the lights because these lights have an infrared and an LED, so we can control the light and what's the pattern of the blinking that we wanted. And in the second case, what we are looking is another project that we are calling it Chroma Screen. And we are creating these eyeshadows that they change color, and we can control when they will change color. So we create these thermochromic pigments, and with a circuit behind it that we could heat it up and change the color of it. Maybe the videos are off. Let me turn it on again. And the last one, we call it screen. So we create also interfaces with LEDs on the body, so you could interact with other objects that have lighting, so you can turn on different lights. You can create gestures with lighting on your body. But also with persistent of vision, we can create a new display just with the movement of your gestures, and you can amplify, have a bigger display in a smallest device. So all these projects, what I have been doing, things on the body. And I was very interesting. It's kind of my passion to create a new device in a way that it looks like your body and people would like to use it. I feel like what's happening today with wearables, we have this new wave of wearables where these big companies are having this partnership with fashion companies. I could believe in the future we will have cosmetic companies partnership with big tech companies. And, well, my future projects will be, instead of creating things on the body surface, I will try to create things in the body surface. So that will be my next step. And so for summarizing, to bring in again all these ideas, what I was showing today to you is this idea of beauty technology to have cosmetics and electronics in a way that we can have skin, fingernails, and hair interfaces that allows you to understand your body, so we can identify different patterns when you touch your hair, when you blink, or when you interact with your fingernails with our body, but also in a way as a controller, triggering other devices. So we believe that beauty technology is a new wearable field, that we are not putting technology in clothes and accessories, we are putting technology on the body surface. We are trying to move cosmetics that are traditional, in a traditional way, that for making you pretty, like my red lipstick, but now to have a new superpower, so making them interactive. And we create novel materials. Novel materials, not that in a way that the cosmetics is a novel materials, but we develop different materials with chemistry and other different processes for simulating these devices. And we are not focused in a specific area. Our aim is to show the possibility of having these technologies in different areas, like arts or music, or in the case of Felipe, for example, in a medical applications. So thank you very much. I hope you have some questions.
Thank you so much. Maybe one question and we'll move to.
So I'm just wondering about the requirements for the power.
So it depends of in each application. For example, my fingernails, I don't need any battery because they work by induction. I have FHTIs and work by induction. The eyelashes, for example, the difference is that I connect the eyelashes with the eyeliner, so I have a circuit hiding into a hair band or in a hair extension in the case of the hair wear. So it depends on the project, and yeah, the battery is one of the challenges that we have when we create skin interfaces. I can mention other challenges. Also, the skin is a totally different platform to work with, because we sweat, because we have different kind of skins, more dry, more oily, different sensitivities. For example, we understand now that for example, for putting these technologies, some people are more sensitive or not. So there is a whole scenario that is not just in a way just to create the electronics. It's also the challenges of how to make it possible to wear. Yeah. So okay, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.